Hello everybody, it is Thursday the 30th of June, the final day of June, everyone's least favourite day of June, I don't know, anyway, who cares, before all the cool kids were doing it, Edward Lewis was doing social eating, anyway, we'll begin right about, well, literally, right now. Why wait? Hello! How are you? Before all of the cool kids were doing it. Have you heard the latest news, everybody? That apparently there's now a section on Twitch called social eating. Social eating, everybody. I mean, who could have come up with that idea? It all seems a little bit coincidental that as my eating biscuit stream starts to take off and become unprecedented, that other people started jumping on that idea, including large companies like Twitch. So, all we have to do now is work out how we switch it to social eating, but only during the bit where we're doing the biscuit stream, because we've got to jump on that hype, right? Gotta jump on that hype. I mean, it seems like the no-brainer thing to do. But also when we do get there, if we do get anybody new in at all, we of course have to make sure that they know that we've been doing it for ages and we're not just jumping on a trend. We are the trendsetters here in this live stream. Everybody in this chat, you're all the trendsetters. Good to see you all. Millstone Barn, Johnny Longwood, Dante 2050, Mrs. Noodles, Draco, Academic Dust, Andy FM, what have you got behind the bar for us today? Shan's here and Mrs. Noodles. Oh, we said Mrs. Noodles already, but it's good to see you. Thank you for joining us and everybody else who is in the chat as well. And all those who will be joining us in the future, greetings to you too, even though you can't hear this right now. Pleppy as well! Hello. And Rob, good to see you too. Then even more viewers, I'm getting Twitter envy, that's right. More viewers, Dini, more viewers! Alright, yes, we have the spreadsheet to prove it. Okay, we've got a biscuit review today, and of course tomorrow is the return of the Bisquiz as well, with my dad, Walter Neil Lewis, will be coming on, and he will be doing the quiz with me versus you guys, the chat. I hope you didn't see that. Did you see that? That was a little spoiler there as to what today's biscuit is as well. Ooh. Keeping the freshness locked in with a paper towel. I think that works. All right, so today, of course, as you all know, we will be closing in on Millstone Barn's ringed Earth-like planet, which is so exciting. And does anybody have any ideas where we should go after that as well? Because, look, it's got to be roughly on the way home. But we should go somewhere else exciting afterwards. But not many jumps to go until Millstone Barn's ring light Earth-like planet. He is in the chat with us, so it's good to see you. I think it is... How many jumps did we say it was yesterday? Well, we'll find out. 15 jumps. And I think you made point about it earlier on in there. So in 15 jumps time, we will be taking a break at Millstone's Earth-like to check it out and see it. I've never seen a ringed Earth like in game before. I've seen photos of stuff like that, but I've never actually seen one in game. So it could all be a dupe as well. It could be Millstone Barn making fun of us all and being like, yeah, there's one over here. There's one over there. And then we get there and there's nothing. It's just an empty shack with a sign on the door that says, gone fishing. Ugh. Okay. Good stuff. Let's make this nice and efficient and quick today as well without jumping. Can anyone hear any sound coming from my game, by the way? Just double check for me. Really, really handy. The party bar shuffle. Shuffle? What's that? Interesting. Bar is all prepped, good stuff. Draco, I've got a cool system. I've found a group of two ELWs and one terraformal HMC. I've got it in a common. Barry Center, I don't even know what that is. All right, that sounds cool. Where is that? Let me know the coordinates of that and we'll go there and you can tell me why that's cool. And I will believe you, sincerely. All right, this is stuck under a chair. Hold on. There are crumbs everywhere in this place. You would expect the cleaners to sort things out, but they have not. Those cleaners. They take my mug away from me. But they don't clean up the crumbs. Hey, Fostike! Thank you very much for joining us. How are you today? I'm feeling good. I'm feeling alright. I feel like I'm on the final little bit of the cold. Like it's still, I feel a little tired still, but I feel like it's sort of wrapping itself up a little bit. So I feel alright. You know, positive. Positive about that. It's basically three planets that we orbit each other. Okay, that's cool. That sounds good. The game sound is quite low. Well, then we should sort that and just put it up. Just give it a little boost.
You know. That's, yeah, that's one.
There you go. I'm sure that'll be slightly better. Fuel feed disengaged. There you go. We can now hear the ship talking at me. Telling me off for doing things that I shouldn't be doing, like flying too close to the stars. Hey, Raijin, how are you? Are you passenger series A? Are you asking me, Raijin? No, I am definitely not. I have had very little. Since you last saw me 2 days ago, I've literally only streamed an hour, so I've done an hour of jumping. And I know that you go on about how you can like do like 1,000 million light years in an hour. Unfortunately, I do not have that jump range currently. And I'm doing fairly efficient jumping, and I think people, you know, in the chat can attest to that. I'm not, there ain't no time being wasted here other than, of course, the scoop. And my fuel scoop is just so rubbish that it takes so long to do it. Look, that's the max, 176. And I try and be as efficient as possible whilst also still checking the system map in case there are any Earthlikes that we may have missed. Moving on. No Earthlikes there, and then I even try and get things charging at the right amount of time without taking any heat damage as well. So I'm trying my best to be as on it as possible. Hey Smintilly, how are you? Thank you very much for joining us here today. This is my live stream, which is all about me jumping all the way home from Beagle Point to Sol. I am about 20,000 light years on my journey, but I've still got a long, 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 long way to go back before, because I had to go a big long way around some big vast expanse thing, and Shan helped us out get there. But of course, a quarter to the hour as well, we do have the biscuit with you as well. Today I'll be trying out the new social eating section of Twitch, which means that I might have to, I don't know, you can change things just on the fly, can't you? Like, you can just literally go into the settings while I'm on the back soon screen, can't I? Change it there, right? And just change it halfway through. Because if not, that's silly. We must take advantage of the new systems put in place by Twitch and jump on the hype train. We started going with the hype train. You know, we started that hype train going with a little push. No time wasting here, everybody. We definitely won't have imaginary beards or floating heads. We definitely shan't have any of that today. They won't make an appearance at all. We're here, 11 jumps to the target. We're making progress. I'm making sense. Wilson Barn isn't there himself, I don't think, but, or he hasn't let me know he is. Oh, we cannot scoop from this planet. I don't want to then, do I? Leave. FSD malfunction! Andy FM, if you could please serve whatever it is that you're drinking or behind the bar. And remember, of course, that the drinks are completely imaginary and do not exist in real life at all. But don't tell Andy FM that, because he has mental problems. And he will get sad if you do let him know that his life is actually just a figment of his own imagination. Yes, we do have a lot of regulars, man. Yes. Mark, we have the same people here every single day, and then it picks up, and they're amazing. They're my favourite people in the world. Bad Cat Willem, good to see you. How are you? Thank you very much for being here. All these names, and Spintilly as well, of course. David, big fan of David's. Pause a totally real shot for everybody. Thank you, Andy FM. What are we serving today again, please? Remember to drink responsibly, drink carefully, and don't drink unless you're operating heavy machinery. Yes, that's definitely the correct health and safety message. Feels quiet today. Bar seems a little quiet, a little sleepy. Oh, Party Bar Shoeful, which is amaretto, melon liquor, peach schnapps, and cranberry juice. Wow. That's very nice. Millstone Barn has come online. Does that mean he's nearby? Oh, also, is anybody doing the countdown for me today as well? We have 35 minutes until today's biscuit review, which yesterday's was a very in-depth biscuit review. With Ross Stack came on, audio engineer, audio designer came on to review the biscuit with me, and he was excellent. But he did, there's no but about it. It was a very in-depth long review. So today's will be a little quicker, a little snappier. Depends on who comes to join us, doesn't it, eh? But tomorrow, of course, remember that we have the Bisquiz with the return of Walter Neil Lewis, the Bisquiz master, to test us all on flight. It will be me versus you guys in the chat, the chatters, as he likes to call you, very affectionately so. Yeah. And then on Saturday, I will be doing a 6-hour bumper stream from 10 a.m. BST until 4 p.m. Just jumping, just pure jumping. I might do some biscuit reviews, perhaps try and pick up a couple of interesting looking things, just to break up the action. Maybe do sort of three, so every 2 hours instead of every hour. Because last time I did have a sugar crash and it freaked me out for the rest of the day. So this time I actually eat something like proper and not drink any tea as well, because that was, the caffeine levels were high. We are approaching, in how many more jumps? 7 jumps time, we will be there. At Millstone Barns, ringed Earth-like planet. Yes, I knew the words would find me eventually. No, there'll be biscuits, Pillhead. I do apologise. There will be biscuits. By the way, hello, Pillhead. Thank you for joining us here today. Is this your first time with the stream, or are you a regular, or are you a lurker, usually, just lurking in the background and you've seen us before, or... It's a new name that I don't recognise. You are more than welcome here, of course. Tell us a little bit about yourself. I did eat a lot of Oreos that day, and I think that I developed type 2 diabetes during that day. Hey, XLG47, thank you very much for joining us. Did you win the prize on Tuesday, by the way? Because I completely forgot to sort you out with it. But I will. So whoever came, if you could please. Oh, you have been a few times. All right, but have you come into the chat much? I feel guilty all of a sudden. I usually remember everybody's name. I remember Twitch names better than I remember real human faces and names. Commander Ben Kai says, do you have a place that you'll post your streaming, if all is okay and you feel like it's scheduled, or do I need to follow you on Twitter? To be fair, it's on here or on Twitter. It's every single day at 1 p.m. really. It's a Twitter thing. I did misread, sent a PM via Twitch, thank you very much. I will get back to you, promise, this afternoon. I'll remember to do it. Yeah, so subscribe to me, yeah, as well, and you'll get an email from Twitch saying when I'm going live. But it is 1 p.m. BST every single day, apart from the weekends, but I'm doing a special this weekend where I start at 10 a.m. Just to do a nice, nice big stream. Kick off the weekend in a fun fashion. Too busy dunking bickies. Now you're a man after my own heart, sir. Pillhead, you can come back. But other than that, like, I should probably put, like, I think there's a stream schedule in down below in here as well. If you look, or maybe I'll use the posting thing as well more on Twitch as well, where I type when we're doing next streams and stuff. But yeah, it should be every single, I think it even says it on the splash screen now, 1 p.m. BST as well. If you ever come to this site, twitch.tv/MTLewis as well, you'll see there. Also tonight as well, if you are around, I'm going to be joining the First Great Expedition on the official YouTube channel, which should be a lot of fun. So I'm going to be doing some synchronized flying with those guys, and apparently it's going to take about 2 hours of my time up. I haven't read their brief fully yet because it's 8 pages long, so that's going to be interesting. But yeah, please do come along and watch that on youtube.com/frontierdevelopments/live tonight at 7 p.m. That should be a good one. How many more jumps we got now? 5 more jumps until we get to appreciate the beauty of an Earth-like ringed planet. Very cool. Looking forward to it. I remember the word today, yeah, synchronized. I think what's happened is that ever since I had this cold last week, which started on Thursday, and I'm still feeling it a little bit today, as you can tell, I'm slowly recovering, and my vocabulary comes back. Because the start of this week and last week was such a mess. It was just me just basically grunting. Like, it may as well have been grunting. It would have made more sense of just making, involuntary noises every now and again. Mark, that's... You go ahead and... You do publish that, I do invite a lot of people to go over to that Discord channel. It's very cool. Some lovely people in there too. Not including Mark, who was terrible. Flippy. Oh yeah, so Friday we've got the 50th Biscuit review as well, which is a pretty crazy big day. So we've got the pub quiz and the 50th Biscuit review, which is really cool. Monday to Friday is flying, but then I do the Biscuit review at the end, yeah, at 1:45. On Tuesdays we now have Treasure Tuesdays, Treasure Chest Tuesdays, where I give away a paint job pack. On Wednesdays we have Guest Wednesdays, when we have a guest from the Frontier Developments come on and review a biscuit with me. And on Fridays we have the Bisquiz, and then we're working out some other days as well. But that's what we've got so far, and you know, we're having we have a nice time here, don't we? Don't we, chat? We have a nice time. I hope you guys have a nice time. We like to keep things personal. We like to have regular communications. Pillar, what's the Great Expedition? The first Great Expedition, you have to be out of the loop for that at all. They're actually a very long-standing group, and they dedicate themselves to exploration. They've been around since like the very, I think it was the Alpha and the Beta times. Obviously, you couldn't do much exploration back then, but as soon as that was possible, they made it their journey, their sort of their main efforts to explore out as far as they can and record lots of data. They have a whole history, and what you'll have to do is come back on tonight at 7 p.m. if you do have the time, or watch it on demand to learn about their group. Because that's what Educating Ed is all about. It's the return tonight of Educating Ed. It's all about showcasing all the small groups. Excuse me. All of the small and big groups, and you know, everybody. It's about showcasing everybody in this community, which is absolutely amazing. Yeah, giveaways Tuesdays, Guest Wednesdays, Freak Out Special Guests Day, Friday Dad's Quiz Night. Yeah, it's not that hard, thank you. That's the schedule. FS email function, if we could please pour another drink out for us on the FM, which is, I've got to remember this, the Party Bar Shuffle, which of course is amaretto, melon liqueur, peach schnapps, and cranberry juice. Sounds tasty. We've got two more jumps to go, and then we'll be arriving at Millstone Barn for Planet. I wonder if he's going to be there. Because I'm in a private group as well. Well, we don't have an official countdowner today, unfortunately. Both Griefed and iGamer17 are away, and they're usually my official counts of down. So today, I can't work out how long we've got because I'm not very good at the maths thing. But I think it's about 26 minutes. Yeah. No, wait. Yeah. 24 minutes. 24 minutes. Is it? Yes, I think it is. No, I'm rubbish. God, I'm so bad at maths. I wish I was actually joking. Checking for Earthlikes. 26 minutes to review, thank you, Shan. Yes! I got it right as well, 26 minutes. Well, I said 24 after that, like an idiot. But here we go, on this jump, we are there. We've arrived at our first destination for the day. What we've got to do is listen, of course, for the wonderful, yeah, you know what I mean. There's some nice music that happens. It's this music. Feels like an accident. The worst dance ever. Just got a shuffle in. Wahoo! Ba 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 da da ba! Celebrate good times. Celebrate good times, come on. We've arrived at Millstone Barn's system. Let's get it scanned and see what goods we can find here. Goodbye! Thank you very much, Cool and the Gang, for helping us celebrate the good times. Come on. Here we go, right! Has the boy done the biscuit stuff yet? No, I've not done the biscuit stuff yet. Wait, are we in the right place? First discovered by Millstone Barn. After all this time, I was correct. And what is this that we see here? Millstone Barn's ringed Earth-like planet. Let's head over there and investigate and see what we can find. Maybe Millstone Barn himself will be there. Looking shifty. Probably not. Probably not, though. Fuel
Yes, thanks for visiting. I'm going to have a go look. We're celebrating the arrival at Millstone Bond's ringed Earth-like planet, which I've never seen before, so we have to go and check it out and get some nice screenshots. It's only 640 light seconds away, so we should be there in no time at all. The 51. Hello. Theo 51. Oh, Theo 51, tongue face. What's happened? Oh, oui. Bonjour. I'm Theo 51. No, I'm Theo 51. Lol. Uh-oh. Pour vérifier si tu es là? We've... D'accord. Okay, we have a... Oh, there's a French conversation happening, which, you know, of course, as a pro-European, I'm very excited about. Greetings, David Gilson. Thank you very much for joining us. 23 minutes, 1,410 seconds until the Biscuits. Thank you very much, Dante, for being incredibly accurate, as you always are. That's very wonderful. We're scanning the planet, which is fantastic. It won't be, obviously, a unique find, but it's still pretty cool. Three houses and two hotels on it, says Shan, which means that I have to now pay what? What's that? Three houses, two hotels? I'm afraid that I'm going to have to sell Pall Mall then to cover this, which is a real shame. I'm going to have to remortgage all my houses on there, which is kind of a dick move, to be completely fair, because now I've got no money and this game's bull pie and I'm flipping the table. Oh, look at this. An anarchy Earth-like world with a ring around it. Ooh. Very pretty. Very cool, right? What's... So I feel nervous about getting close to it. But of course, we need to celebrate our visit here with a screenshot. Look at that. Incredible. It's beautiful. They should have sent a poet, instead they sent me. For some really strange reason, they have sent me, and I'm almost entirely an idiot. Why would they send me? 4K screenshot taken. Oh, in fact, let's get rid of my face as well. Look at that. Beaut, what a beaut. Yeah, that's gonna be pretty amazing. That's awesome stuff. What pawn am I? The shoe, the hat, the car? I'm definitely the dog of the car. Before pancakes in the ring, I'm not going to do that. It's going to be my... Yeah, I had to step away. What planet is this? This is an Earth-like, but a ringed Earth-like planet all the way here. I'm going to show you on the galaxy map where it is. All the way out this way here. Look at that. Wonder if it point one. What? Yeah, hello? What are you doing here? I'm really confused as to why that's called Rendezvous Point. I know I probably should know these things, but sometimes this game baffles me. So I'm miles away. That's where it is. If you want to go and visit, that's Millstone Barnes Earth-like. And I think that's beautiful. Thank you so much for letting us come and visit Millstone. It's a beautiful little place you've got here. 26 minutes to the review. So I'm going to start moving things away now. It was a nice time. We had a nice visit, a nice little visit there. Let's get a little bit further away and get a nice screenshot of us leaving. Which will be quite nice, I think. So, roll it until we get some sunlight. And then, zoom out. I want to turn orbit lines off, really. Oh, quick. Bye-bye! Bye! Everyone wave to Millstone Barnes Earth-like. Bye. Look at it disappear off into the distance. Right, next. Where are we off to next, guys? Rendezvous point was where there was a meeting with two commanders, one of them Ranger and his Sidewinder. Ah, okay. Biscuit reviews tune to my 18-year-old son, Oscar. Oscar says hi, and you have the best job ever. Yes, I do, Oscar. Everyone say hello to Oscar and admit that, yes, this is the best job in the world. It's, look, we do get to have a good time. It's part of, it's just one little part of what we do. Where should I go? Does anybody have any idea where we should go? Or should we just point back towards Sol or back towards Sagittarius A and start moving in that general direction? Because, hey, that's where we're going. So to be fair, I'm not going to make it 1,000 light years anyway at this point because we've got 26 minutes until the next biscuit review. But let's set ourselves up with roughly 1,000 light years to travel. Because why not? Bookmark it. There you go. So let's go. Let's begin. We have we've done some good things. 761 light years in 31 jumps. So as you can see as well, the number of jumps that it's taking now at this point is starting to lessen because I think it's just simply because there's more options. So it's just much more of a direct route. So we've done it. We've done it, everyone. We've done it. We've made it out. Everyone, I seriously want to say thank you to everybody for doing this and sticking me with this far because this is crazy. But Shan, thank you so much for helping me out and getting me this far. Dante, all of you guys, wonderful, wonderful, lovely people. It was lovely to meet you actually in person as well, Draco. That was good. Ah, yeah, that's right. It's where the first of meeting from Sarsa, the guys took place with Aramis and Ranger. We should probably go there then, shouldn't we? Seems like the thing to do. We're heading sort of that way anyway, right? Let's head to Rendezvous Point. Why not? Seems it's got a fancy name. We should do it. Are there any other places with fancy names that we should visit? Hey, Orange Spark. You don't have to apologise. You were going to be the official countdown today, but you've been usurped by Shan. He says, 20 minutes to biscuit review. Smiley face. Detour to Jack's we could do, but by the time I get there, remember that I'm only doing an hour of jumping a day, and then on Saturday I'm doing some extra jumping, but like the amount of jumps that I'm going to get to do are very limited, so by the time I actually get there, who knows where Jack's is going to have, or if Jack's has moved by that point, so we'll find out if he's actually going to be there or not, but it's a cool idea. So I'm just trying to check, I've got like loads of messages going on. Okay, we have about 20 minutes until the day's biscuit review. If you are just joining us, welcome. Thanks for being here. It's so good to see you all. You're getting tomorrow, by the way, just a quick reminder, is the return of the Biscuits with Walter Neil Lewis. I want to see as many people in the chat for tomorrow's Biscuits because my dad has just come out of hospital and he can't wait to come and see you guys and do the quiz with us. Remember, it's you versus me, which is always very unfair. Maybe I'll get a guest on tomorrow to help me. Yeah, maybe we'll do that because I need. And what would be amazing is having David Braben himself on because he is a mastermind of almost everything. So he should have the best. He's incredible with general knowledge. But I don't think we'll get him. In fact, I think he might be off on a holiday this week. Don't tell anyone. Oh no, he's been here the entire time. Everyone say hello to David, please. He's in his green screen suit right next to me, making sure that I stay toward and make sure I say all the right things. He stands in the green screen suit right there. There's his. Poking his face now. It's definitely his face. Sorry. Please say hi to David. Thank you. He's not really there, everybody. It's a joke. FSD malfunction. Can you pour every time we have an FSD malfunction? Because, of course, I've come all this way and I forgot to bring an AFMU, which is an auto field maintenance unit, which means that every now and again my FSD drive fails. So, every time we do, we have Andy FM, who is in the bar in the back of the ASP. Sorry, the back, which is that way, because I'm facing into the ASP weirdly. Back of the ASP, we've got a bar which is called the Mars Bar, the space bar at the edge of the galaxy. And Andy FM is the barman there. And he's pouring his drink. Today we have some sort of party drink. I can't remember what it was. But it's full of cranberry and schnapps and all sorts of stuff. Amaretto, I think, is in there too. It's madness.
I'd love David to be the guest for 50, but like I say, I think he's on holiday, so I'm not sure if he's going to see it. I should have remembered which one he was. Can't find him. Where is he? Is this him? Nope. That's not him. There he is. Hey, David. He's back. He's arrived. Jumping now. Why is he gone? He's disappeared again. There he is. Jumping now to the Braden system. Jumping now. We will reach there. On time. You won an Assassin's Pack on the Broken Windows 10 stream last week and you've not received it yet. Should I have by now? Yes, you should have by now. Please do send me an email again to elewis@frontier.co.uk being like, I won an Assassin's Pack on the Broken CQC stream and I demand answers. Say that in a really demanding way so I can forward it on to the person who's responsible for adding those specifically to the account and they can feel guilty about it. That's a joke. I don't want to make anyone feel guilty. It's nobody's fault other than my own. Alright guys, do stick around because very soon, in about 13 minutes time, we will be having the biscuit review of the day. Hopefully, I'm not too, you know, I'm not too hopeful about these personally, but they are a unique biscuit that hasn't been done before, so I'm looking forward to seeing what you guys think as well. But do stick around for that. That's a quarter of the hour, of course, and let's go try and get as many people in as possible. And remember as well, of course, and I said this early on when we first started, but now you can set things to social eating. And I would think it's ridiculous. Like, I'm the kind of person who would have been like, this is why do people like watching other people eat things on a stream? But when, now that I've done these, I'm like, oh yeah, good. I'm glad that they've done that. And it all seems a little bit coincidental that Twitch suddenly put this on after, of course, us doing our streams. By the way, I am joking. I don't think that my stream alone has caused them to do an entire category just for me. Fragged85 says, those biscuit things make me hungry. Sorry. I do apologise. That's what it's all there for, though. It's supposed to make your... I'm giving you reliable buyer's advice. You know, it's just my opinion. It's like a video game review. It's just my opinion. We're just trying to make, you know, trying to help you with some reliable opinion. That's all it is. Although I'm not sure anyone would ever call my opinion reliable. That's for sure. You found my tweet pick of where it's just been. Oh, wow. Cool. Have a look now. Whoa, yeah, yours is better. You spent more time. That's really cool. It's awesome. I'll reply to it with my picture later. Alright, Commander Benkai has got the best idea possible. Yes, tomorrow is the beach party 50th biscuit review. Yes, we're all holding a beach party. It is the summer. That's the best idea I've ever heard. Tomorrow we're doing a beach party. That's it. I can sort it all out myself. We're going to go to the beach. We're going to wear sandals and everything. And we're all going to have a 50th beach party. What should we do? Now that everyone's here. Finally, all my guests have arrived. What biscuit are we going to review tomorrow? On Friday? Tomorrow? It's tomorrow. Oh God. What a quick week this has been. Because if we all decide now what it can be, then people at home can pick it up too. And when we have our beach party... Biscuit review beach party, which is the best and craziest idea I've heard. Straw hats at the beach. Not sure. What else do we have at the beach? I'm not sure I really have any appropriate beach wear. I want to dress up like a Victorian beach. No mankies allowed. Live Skype link to where David is on a beach right now. I don't know if he's literally on that kind of holiday. I just mean that he had like a day of leave. Cocktails? Yes, we can have cocktails. What have we got here? Nothing. A hanky on head.
That's what I'm thinking. Hanky on head, really high shorts, and then like a stripey top. That's what we're going to go for. Sun cream. Just too much sun cream on the nose. Mm-hmm. How about do a head-to-head top 55 elimination biscuit review? That's good fun. Ben Kai, while Commander Coots isn't here, who is usually the assistant producer, you can now be the assistant to the assistant producer if you want, because you're coming up with all of the best ideas today. Where is Coots when you need him to tell him off, to reprimand him? Beach biscuits. Beach theme. What's this beach theme? I mean, I enjoy the beach theme. It's fairly irrelevant, but that's fine. That's okay. FSD malfunction, please. Andy FM, if you could pour the fifth drink of the day. Done quite a lot of jumps today. We're doing well. We're making some serious time. All right, so we've got the biscuit review in 7 minutes. 7 minutes time. Well, you might be at the beach. No wonder the response is so slow during the meetup. Yeah, it's 45 seconds. You've timed it. Draco, 10 minutes to biscuit review. Oh, I see. Yes. Interesting. No, it's shot number four. Thank you. Wow. Cup of tea for me as well, yeah. I'm feeling that. I'm feeling a little rough. This cold just won't. It's like such a lingering, like, cold, like, clinging onto my throat. There's something inside there, I'm sure. Like a little alien chap. A Thargoid, if you will. The face hugger or a Thargoid. You choose. You choose your preference. Your alien preference. Celebration music there to make sure everyone's feeling cheerful and ready for the biscuit review, which begins in about 6 minutes. I've clicked away from the screen, which is bad news. Right, let's hover for a few seconds. Take a little break, sit back and relax while the fuel scoop does its work. Ed's beach get up confirmed. Let's have a look at this. Yep, there we go. That's exactly it. That's exactly what I was thinking. Look a little bit like this. Takes too long to get these images on. There we are. There's me tomorrow. A particularly strange look. But, you know, it has been voted by the attentive viewers, that's what I'm going to be wearing tomorrow. I can't promise that I'll be wearing that because, well, it's a little bit strange and maybe slightly offensive. But there you go. Hey, who knows? Hi, Mark Tavox, how are you doing? Mark Tavox. Bricks. I don't understand any of what's going on there. I haven't seen that sketch in a long, 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 long time. Hooligans, yeah. Follower calls, yeah, right as fuck. I do have some cutout outfits that have been made for me. Oh, do we have, is that an Earthlike? No! Metallic, most likely. Terraformable, is it far enough away? Too far away for a terraformable? Can somebody remind me, please? That'd be really, really cool. Oh, like skins in Overwatch. Yeah. Just literally play more and eventually FSD malfunction. It's shot number 5 of the day. How much can we bear this day if FSD malfunctions? We'll all be staggering our way back to our desks after work with the amount of party drink that we're having as well. Remember that tomorrow, if you are just joining us, is the 50th Biscuit review, which is big news. But we also have the Bisquiz return of Walter Neil Lewis, my dad. He'll be coming on Skype. He sits up in that corner over there. Like that. Don't get out of the green screen. He sits up in that corner. Far one, all the way over in the top where you can see the communication space. Sits up there and he does the quiz between me and you, the chat. So do turn back up tomorrow, please, for the Biscuits review, because it's the most exciting part of the week for me. See you in the old pop! High metal content, go get it. Go get it. Yes, it's a Spark. Too late. Sorry. Sorry, Spark. I ignored you entirely. I was too busy trying to promote the rest of my streams this week. Serving water tomorrow. No, thank you. What about this one? Is that good enough for you? Fuel scoop disengaged. Well, and this one. There's a couple that are really good here. I don't know. Screw these things. If they ain't Earth-likes, then I'm not interested. I just want to get home. And these take far too long. 3:30 between 7:30. Thank you very much, Draco. Orange Spark, you've got a new job tomorrow. And you're starting your new job. Well, congratulations. Everybody, round of applause, please, for Orange Spark in the chat, who is starting a new job tomorrow. Brandon C. Mallory says he can't stand the excitement and you fear you may explode. Well, we all have that feeling when it comes towards the end of the week. And I understand. I understand where that comes from. But we've made some pretty good tracks today. How many jumps have we done? We're at, like, quite a lot. Let's have a look where we're at in terms of our distance to Sol. A couple more jumps first before we then move on to the Biscuit review. But yeah, we're doing quite well. There's interesting stuff popping up all over the place here. These systems are starting to be really, really interesting. Let's get in and get in 7.6 quickly. Before we then move to the next system. I keep forgetting that on these long long periods where I'm scanning for, where I'm scooping for a long time, that I may as well scan the star, but it's just like one more thing to remember to do every single time. And as we know, I am mostly a moron, so it takes me a long time. Like, I'm already doing a lot of stuff at once. 2 minutes until the review. Thank you very much, Shinari Rinale. You have been a wonderful, wonderful countdown host today. Zimmer Onain, as-tu à te voir vivre quand ils majorisent? C'est quoi? It's in a store. It's in a store, says Orange Spark. Well done. Yes. Okay. Selling phones on the street. It's a mobile job. And that's why we let Commander Benkai come back to these things. Classic knee slappers such as that. Wonderful times. All right, one more jump, and then we're going to do it. It's been a team countdown effort today. You're right, it has. It's been very good. It's really good to see you all. Right, jumping one final jump, and then I'm going to check and see how much progress we've made. We've done pretty well. I need a kettle cam. Oh my god, a kettle cam. Like a really sort of lo-fi, just like... what's it called? We could have CCTV footage of just me running in, making the tea, and coming back. All right. Maybe we'll do a pretend kettle cam or something. Awesome. Thank you, Draco. I do apologise. Have you? Sorry. Oh, you have as well. Sorry, I thought it was Shem. Yeah. You, again, group effort. Thank you. Sorry for not noticing. All right, remember that we're going to be having the Sagittarius A meetup soon as well. So if you are interested in the Sagittarius meetup, you have to talk to Shan in the chat here about getting involved in that private group, because, of course, we have to make sure that we trust absolutely everybody. We'll be meeting up at Sagittarius A very soon as part of my way back home. Let's see almost exactly how far away we are from, first of all, Sol, which is the overall ultimate goal all the way from where I am currently. 53,196, that's... We started off at 65,000, but of course we had to go a long, long, long way round. So we are slowly chipping away at that now. And then, of course, let's not forget how to spell Sag. It in one. 27,000 light years away. So at this rate, we'll be there in 27. But of course, I'm going to do about 6,000. This thing's 20 days. So we'll be there in about 4 weeks' time. Well, it depends. We'll see. We'll see how many we can do, and hopefully we can get some longer live streams sorted out and things like that anyway. Has anybody told me off yet that the review starts now and then it's time for me to go away and go to the back soon screen and change my settings so that we can go into social food eating zone and things like that? No, nobody has. Usually they would. But hey, I'll go and do that right now. All right, lovely people. I will be back in 2 minutes. You know how this works. Please go and tell all of your friends that the biscuit review starts in about 2 minutes' time. Thanks very much, and I'll see you in a second. Bye. All right, it is time, of course, because it's quarter to the hour. Well, that's just about 10 to now. But anyway, that means, of course, I got myself a fresh brew of Yorkshire tea. Wait for it.
Yorkshire tea, the only tea for me. And yeah, beginning now with today's biscuit.
Here we go. So, today's biscuit review, of course. Let's continue on our biscuit experience. The biscuit extravaganza. Extravaganza, I guess we're going to take a gander at some biscuits and have an extravaganza. But of course, we can't do that without the official biscuit tasting Excel spreadsheet. Ooh, the Excel spreadsheet, as you can see around me, falling around me are these numbers, tumbling around me in a sea of numbers. I'm overwhelmed by the numbers. Of course, we have at the very top the appearance, the taste, the texture, the durability, the dunkability, the post-dunk taste, the satisfaction, the Moorishness, and the total. All right. So, where did they grow Yorkshire tea? China, probably. I don't know. All right, so today's biscuit, of course, will it be exceed the Hotel Chocolat salted caramel handmade shortbread? Or will it be sitting at the bottom with a Tesco rich tea finger? Or can it perhaps go somewhere in the middle with the Oreo peanut butter flavour or the Tesco bourbon cream? The 49th biscuit that we'll be reviewing today, because of course number one's column is not free because it is named, which is annoying, so maybe I should get an order thing and thing. Anyway, I don't know, we'll get to that point. All right. We've dealt with it this far. Today, people, ladies and gentlemen, we have the amazing, the wonderful, well, we'll find out if it's wonderful, won't we? The Party Ring by British supermarket store Sainsbury's. Not Party Ring, that's wrong. I'm giving you false information now. What kind of biscuit science is this where you receive false information? I do apologise. We have the coconut ring by Sainsbury's today in today's biscuit review live stream. Thank you very much for joining us. If you are joining us, we do these biscuit reviews every single day at 1:45 on my lunch break at work. I work as the community manager at Frontier Developments. So if you are seeing for this for the first time, I usually play a little bit of Elite first, which is an awesome game. And then we go and review some biscuits at 1:45. Welcome to the stream. Do hit the follow button if you haven't already. I'm going to write that down into the database. We have the coconut ring by Sainsbury's, which is, if you don't know, a British supermarket. It's spelled right. Oh, that's very unfortunate spelling there. Coconut ring by Sainsbury's. All right, so first of all, we go by its appearance. I have two here for comparison, so you can see how they come out of there. Of course, unfortunately, there is no points for packaging in this live stream, as you know. So here we go. Let's have a look at that. So as you can see, they're quite nicely ridged. And they've got that crosshatch on the back as well. We all know that I like a crosshatch. And also, they can act as eyes. If you have two of them, you can look through them and use them as a toy to entertain children at a party if need be. But you shouldn't do that because you should never play with your food. This is serious business. All right, here we go. I don't know. I like the ridging of them. I like the round shape. There's a little bit of a glazing on there, which is quite nice, but I'm not too sure how appealing that is to me. I do like the ridging. It kind of looks like almost like a planet surface that you could land on, maybe. So I'm gonna go for something around the 6.2 mark because I do like the round shape. It's kind of neat, but it's not wonderfully appealing. In fact, I'm knocking down a point because I think it looks a little bit, unfortunately, like a part of the human body. Taste, let's go for it. This is a coconut ring rumour, so I'm going to be judging it on how coconutty it is, as well as how sort of sweet and buttery it feels. Let's go. A distinct lack of coconut. It's a coconut ring. Uka B has got a very good point there. Thank you very much for joining us, by the way, Uka B. You've got a very good point there that it does have a very nice crisp bite to it. And in fact, the British supermarkets, I've got to tell you, they really, really do get the biscuit base correct. We've done a lot of American biscuits on here. As you can see, we've done over 50 biscuits on this review so far. And a lot of the American biscuits and the European biscuits even don't get that biscuit base correct, whereas the British supermarkets, they get those, making Britain great again. That's a joke. By keeping our supermarkets doing good biscuit bases. But taste, it's all right. It's got a good aftertaste. I feel good about it now, but it's not overwhelming and there's not enough coconut in there. It's a bit too buttery. It's not quite sweet enough for my personal tastes in there. But the texture is actually, I would say, is a good. It's good. They just get that biscuit base just right. And there's like a little nice, the sugary little, so you can, I don't know if you can see on the camera, the sugary sort of crystally, sugary bits that you can get on the sort of glinting away. They're just really nice on the tongue. They're just really, really, really good there. So I'm doing well. Durability, of course, is based around how much of a job that... Oh, Henry the Hoover here. So, yeah. I mean, he's quite rude. Shouldn't really go around saying things like that to people, but he does. Sometimes you just can't control this guy. But he's got a job and a half to do right now, right down here. But he's done a fine job of it. But basically, there are quite a few crumbs here, and they did snap apart quite easily. I'm going to go for a 6.4. Is everybody okay with a 6.4? Oh god, now I've got to move me. This is a disaster. Moving me now. There you go. There I am. Dunkability, everybody's favourite part of the dunkability test. Are we ready? Frontier cup here, by the way, because unfortunately Shan's, the biscuit mug is unavailable today for some reason. It's a shocker. Alright, you ready? 1, 2, 3, and remove. It's showing some signs of sagging already. It's gone. It's a goner. It didn't even survive 1 3-second dunk. That's bad news for this biscuit, unfortunately. I had such high hopes for the coconut ring halfway through. I thought it was doing very well, but the dunkability showed very, very poorly indeed. It's a 5. It's a 5. A flat 5. It fell right in there. I could see it. However, that doesn't mean that the taste... Oh, it's falling apart on the desk in front of me. This is a disaster. Are we ready? Okay. Mmm. Yeah. Yep. It's got a good post-dunk taste. It definitely improves on the initial taste. Probably ups it by about 0.3. The satisfaction, the overall feeling of finishing one of the biscuits, apart from covering the desk entirely in... oh dear. Entirely in crumbs and mulch. Mmm. Nah, Pillhead. See, you're mistaking there. If it was to have fallen apart as it was being dunked, and I pulled it out and it had gone entirely, that would be a 1, 2, 3. If it survives the dunk and holds there for a few seconds, that is at least a 5. It did hold it for a couple of seconds, so I think it does deserve the 5. The satisfaction, my overall feeling about the coconut ring by Sainsbury's is... Give me a second to think about this, because it's an important decision. It's more of an emotional... I take it so seriously, thank you Frag85, it's very important to me that this is a serious science. It's not a joke, alright? We have my emotional feeling about this. It's a 6.8. Moorishness, I do want another, but how many more could I take? Mmm. 2, 3, or 4 happens. I don't know. We don't know. No riots. No riots allowed. This is a subjective live stream, but it is scientifically accurate too. Moorishness, I don't know. I want another. I want another one. It's a 7.5. Alright, let's get the total. 53.7, everybody. And of course, as we know, because I don't know how to do it any other way, we're going to order it here like this. And we can see where it's stood up against the other biscuits. We have it at position 35. Of 49. So tomorrow, if you are new to this live stream, this is the first time you've been here, we have our 50th biscuit review tomorrow. And also, we do the Bisquiz, where my dad comes on to the chat and he does a quiz. Tomorrow it's about flight. Not about biscuits, but it doesn't matter. Originally it was. He comes on, he stands up there in Skype in the corner, he tells a little story about me, and then we have a quiz, me versus you guys in the chat. But that is today. The best biscuit Frag 85 currently stands as the Hotel Chocolat Salted Caramel Handmade Shortbread.
very, very good premium biscuit. Closely followed by Thomas J. Fudge's decadent dark chocolate Florentines, and then the Fox's Chunky Cookie is probably the most sort of widely bought one in supermarkets. But I'm going to put this up online for people to check in case that they haven't been able to keep up with all of the biscuits as a good buyer's guide for people at home. So, everybody, all you lovely, lovely people, Gregor Burns, Millstone Barn, Commander Benkai, Dante 2050, Bran, all of the regulars, thank you so much for coming along today. You've been absolutely amazing. And if you haven't, if this is your first time, do come back. You are welcome here. We do have a nice time. We stream every single day at 1 p.m. BST. And I do I move on to do the biscuit roux. So hit that follow button if you do want to. And yeah, I will see you all tomorrow. So yeah, see you soon. Bye. Thank you, everybody. See ya. Bye. Just so you're aware, everyone, I was doing social eating before social eating was cool. I'm the king of social eating. I've been social eating for weeks before you were even born. Social eating. Celebrate!